why I would buy a Paul Reed Smith guitar over a Gibson Les Paul, sight unseen. Baxter at Casino Guitars right here. One more thing, click the subscribe button, click that bell for notifications. Thank you for watching. Okay, we're talking about Paul Reed Smith guitars and Gibson Les Pauls, which I love both and own both, unfortunately, to my wife's dismay. Far too many. I only own one PRS, but and a lot of Gibsons, and a lot of Les Pauls, and a lot of other Gibson things. Okay, we're talking about quality control. First and foremost, off the bat, there's nothing really that I've come across, I hate saying it, that we open these up, they play perfectly, they're set up perfectly, they're intonated perfectly, they sound pretty darn perfect. It frustrates me. I don't want to like this guitar as much as I do. This is a David Grissom, and this is a 10 top. Looks like a McCarty type of burst here. It's awesome. It's beautiful. It does. It frustrates me. And I got over here a Gibson Custom Shop RO, which is also an awesome guitar. Now, this one required a little bit of setup out of the box. This is why we're doing this video. Just to kind of give you an idea of some of the work that goes into it. Now, we do love Gibson Les Pauls. Love, love, love them. But if you're buying something on the internet and you haven't had your hands on it, especially if you're going to one of the big box shops, which are fantastic, some of them, be careful. Because a lot of these guitars come straight from the factory. They sit in the box. They might come out for a quick picture, go right back in. This whole setup thing doesn't often happen. We've had people work in these big box shops. It's guaranteed. But so when you get a Paul Reed Smith, these are coming straight out of the factory. We open them up, we don't have to set them up. It kind of takes a lot of our work out of our job, which frustrates us too. They're easy to play, they're fluid, they have a fantastic sound, and that's kind of it on the PRS. Now, when it comes to Les Paul, I still might want to get one of these, but sight unseen is a little tricky. I'd like to get my hands on it, because they do play differently. Sometimes they're a little bit harder to play, sometimes they definitely need a setup, but it is a Les Paul, and there's really nothing cooler than a Les Paul. So, if I have, if I had my druthers, I don't know. I think I'd want to have one of each, but that's not really possible. Well, it is for me, but it's not, no, not really, because my wife will kill me. I would stick with a PRS if I'm ordering online. If you're contacting us, any of your indie friends out there, or any of your big box shops, talk to them about the PRS selection. If you want something that's going to be guaranteed, set to go. I've never seen an error on a core piece, and be playing right out of the box, and being wowed. We did not do a thing to this when I played the demo on it a few minutes ago. And I was frustratedly wowed the entire time. I was like, oh, wow, ooh, ah. This is cool too. It was a little bit more work and we're gonna tweak it some after we get this video done shooting too. But thanks for watching. That's my two cents. Baxter Clement Casino Guitars signing out. Happy America Day. Always?